So this is the kitchen so far. Justin is about to get started on the backsplash. He's gonna do our tile work and we're bringing it all the way up. So I think it's just gonna give it a little bit more of a dramatic effect and look really nice. But as you can see, our backsplash does not match what we've got going on here. And then this is what the countertop is looking like. We had these brought in Thursday and today is Saturday. So we're gonna get started on this backsplash and then we will be done with the kitchen. Daddy is amazing. He said daddy is amazing right now.
Somebody does not like all the hammering and stuff going on in here. What's going on, babe? Come on. You can come out from under there.
Oh,
it's not that bad.
Gotta come see mommy.
So Justin just left to go to Home Depot and get some more stuff to like sheetrock the wall. And I've got the kids playing here. I've been trying to keep them occupied to stay out of the kitchen all day. So I bought some Play-Doh, some new, nice, fluffy, squishy Play-Doh. But hopefully this will keep them occupied and keep them out of the kitchen.
And they're trying to distract us.
I am, I'm trying to distract you so you don't go in the kitchen.
Does anybody want to go to Lowe's? You want to go to Lowe's with me? Yeah? You ready to go? Oh, he's got it in his mouth.
He said, let's go.
You ready?
So me and Mr. Bailey are up here at Lowe's. I went to Home Depot this morning. I picked up a bunch of supplies that I thought I was gonna need for this project. And I forgot one thing that I needed to, well, actually I didn't forget it. I thought I had a bunch of, it was wire nuts. I thought I had a bunch of them in my garage at the house. So I did not pick any up. And I got home and when it came time for that part of the project, I realized that I don't have any wire nuts. So I'm running back up here to Lowe's with Bailey and we're gonna pick up a couple of those and we're gonna get back to work. This project has come along pretty quickly. It's come along pretty good. I guess there's a few more delays than I thought, but all in all, I think I'm moving pretty quickly for what I'm getting done. What you think, Bay? You ready to go inside? You ready to go?
Yeah.
Bailey's loving this, although all the shopping carts really scare him. They are too scary. Make too much noise.
Finished this kitchen. I've got the backsplash here, across the top, and across the top up here, and I love the way it turns out. Megan likes it. It matches really well with what we've got going on, and it's got a very clean look to it, which I love. So
I'm gonna get into a couple tips to give y'all, just not that I'm that experienced, but I did learn a few things along the way. Before I do that, I want to say thanks to Audible for sponsoring today's video. You can get your first audiobook for free plus 2 audio originals from Audible when you try Audible for 30 days. You get that by going to www.audible.com/Hickman, or for US viewers, you can text Hickman to 500-500. Now, I love to listen to Audible, especially at a time like this, whenever I'm working on a project, because I can just turn on, set it, and just listen to it like that. And I love that. Also, I do it a lot, like driving down the road when I'm by myself, or in the plane. That's where I do it a lot. And that's one really cool thing about Audible, is that you can actually download the titles. Like, you get the free app on your phone, whether it's smartphone, whether it's Android or Apple product or whatever. You download the free app, you sign up for your account, and then you can go in there and you actually download the book into your app. So you don't even have to be hooked up to Wi-Fi. You can do it on the airplane with no issues.
A great audiobook that I've been listening to lately is The Millionaire Real Estate Investor, which is all about like fixing and flipping real estate and houses and renting out houses and stuff like that. So it's been very fitting considering I've been doing my own projects here on this house.
Audible Originals are exclusive audio titles created by celebrated storytellers from everything from theater to journalism. Got all kinds of stuff, and Audible has an unmatched number of titles. I'm telling you, everything that I've ever searched for on Audible has been in there, so it's really been great. You can get your first free audiobook plus 2 of those Audible Originals by trying Audible for 30 days, and you can get that by going to www.audible.com/Hickman, or if you're in the US, you can text Hickman to 500-500. So now let me get into some of these tips really quick. One of the first things that happened to me was I started taking off the old backsplash that was in here. Y'all remember the tan looking backsplash? When I took it off, it was ripping up the sheetrock that was under it, because the mortar that was under it was actually just like ripping the sheetrock off the wall. And I thought that was gonna be terrible, because I'm like, oh great, now I've got to do some sheetrock work.
So I have never done backsplash before, and I thought that the tile was going to come off of here a lot easier than it did. But as you can tell, in a lot of places, I was ripping the sheetrock clean out of there. But then there are some spots, like here, where it's not bad. Like, that's just the paper that's missing right there, so that doesn't need to be patched or anything. But over here on this other side, where the stove is, it's pretty rough. I'm gonna have to definitely do some patching there, replacing sheetrock and stuff, so that's definitely gonna add to my day for sure.
But after I had put the sheetrock up, I realized that was actually a blessing in disguise, because it was so much easier to do the backsplash work over clean sheetrock rather than having to sand off the remaining mortar that was left behind from ripping the tiles off. So I'm telling you, if you start one of these projects and you find yourself even thinking about taking off the sheetrock that's behind there, or if you accidentally rip the sheetrock or something, don't worry about it, because that's actually better. Like, getting that old mortar off was a pain in the few areas that I had to, so I actually really liked that I had to replace a lot of that sheetrock. Another thing is, I started off using this mortar. It's made by Mapei. When I started putting up the mortar, or what some people call it, mastic, when I started putting it on the wall, I was using this stuff from Home Depot, and I really liked this. I used some of it, and then I ran out, and I went and got the kind that Lowe's had, and I didn't like it as much. It was runny, it just wasn't as good of a stick. And I wanted the premium kind. That's another tip. Make sure you get the premium kind that you put this on the wall, and then when you stick your tile to the wall, you can just stick it on the wall and then let it go. It's gonna stay. You don't have to worry about holding it there or propping it up on something or whatever. You stick it to the wall, it's there, it's done. Another tip would be to get the kind of tile like I got that has the built-in ridges right here, so you don't have to use spacers. I put these up, and when you put them together, they're automatically made so they leave a grout line in there. They left a 1/16 of an inch for a grout line, which was what I wanted. If you get the kind that doesn't have that, when you put them together, you have to put the spacers in between. First of all, you have to buy a bunch of spacers, and then you put all the spacers in between, and then you've got to come back and remove those spacers before you grout. It's just extra work. But these were actually, they have the little tabs on there so that whenever you put them together, they automatically create a grout space, and that was much better. The one drawback of using these beveled tile is that they are beveled, and so the issue I came across with that was whenever I was using the grout float to put the grout up, it would want to put the grout in the beveled area but not actually like down in the grout line. And I'm sure it's probably a technique kind of thing, but for me it was just really hard. kind of on that same subject with the grout. This was the grout that I used. And I'm sure it's a technique thing. I'm sure there's plenty of people watching this that have put up a lot of grout before in your life. You don't know what you were doing, and I sure didn't know what I was doing because I've never done it before. But I found that the grout made a big mess, at least the way that I was doing it. So definitely make sure you cover your countertop or your surface or whatever, because when I would scoop it out of here and go to the wall and start to go, it was dripping and clumping off because it was kind of, I don't know, it was kind of like kinetic sand or something. Like it was just like globbing down. So I would end up going across it. And then what I ended up doing more often than not was actually picking up what was dropping with my hands. And I was just putting that into the cracks there where the grout was supposed to go. So got my hands really dirty doing that. But I found that was a little bit easier than to keep trying to scoop and go across. I just felt like this wasn't giving me good coverage like it should have. And again, I'm sure it's just a technique thing, but I did not have the technique and I found using my hands was easier. I did use a lot of this Karakalk. I believe I got this at Home Depot too, if I remember correctly. Oh, it's made by the same people, Mapei. It's made by the same company. This is actually sanded grout in a tube, which is what I was using, was sanded, white sanded grout. I started using this because I had a few areas that were too tight to get this into, and it was just kind of weird spots and also along some of the edges and stuff like that. This stuff was amazing. I thought it was way easier than doing this. So I actually started off doing it by necessity along the top because it was just real tight between the ceiling and the top of the cabinet was really tight right there. So I started using the caulk gun to get in there. And once I started that, I realized how much easier that was than using this thing. So I don't know if there's some rule about not using this on the whole entire wall or not. I don't know. But if I was to do a whole wall and somebody said it was okay, I would use the caulk tube for the whole wall. I'd just run each of the cracks all the way down and come back and make the notches. This was way easier. Now, even doing this, you still have to come back with your finger or something, you know, and kind of smooth it out to make sure that it's right to fit it into the hole. But other than that, this was way easier to me than using the grout float and the bucket of grout. I'm sure there's several things that I'm forgetting. I feel like I had more tips than this in my head whenever I was going around doing the project. I was like, oh, I need to talk about this in the video later, and I can't remember them. But I do know that Megan put up her kitchen reveal a few days ago, and y'all seem to be loving it. In the end of that video, she has a lot of tips like these about saving money, some ways that we save money in the project, some ways that we kind of dress things up a little bit more than just putting up the backsplash. But it definitely go over there and check that video out to get a few more of those tips. I hope y'all enjoyed today's video, especially if you are planning a backsplash project. I know a lot of people have commented saying, hey, make sure you're vlogging this, make sure you're telling us how to do this because we have a backsplash project coming up. So I hope you enjoyed today's video and thank you for watching. Y'all have a good night.